Ever since humans have been to Antarctica, scientists have been finding frozen objects buried and preserved in ice for years and years, below the sea too, and some of them are stranger than others. Some of them happen to be so bizarre that they leave scientists completely mind blown. And it's not only objects that have found, but secrets, answers, and even more.
You can see, even though he's frozen in ice.
Sure, some of these findings are from the Ice Age, but some are brand new and simply unexplainable. These are some of the most intriguing findings ever. 15 jaw-dropping discoveries found frozen in ice. Frozen alien crop circle eggs. When people start buzzing over a random unexplained video on the internet, the court of public opinion can be all over the place with opinions. This time, however, this video has people keeping quiet, maybe a little bit nervous. It was shot by two friends somewhere in Utah. While walking on a frozen lake, two friends came across a dark shape on the ice. They cautiously approached it, wary of the creaking ice sheet. The dark circle was melting ice with a pitted surface like the face of a sunflower. Bizarrely, the icy mass was a perfectly circular shape, permeated with small holes radiating from the center. A voice is heard saying, "Maybe it's aliens. Maybe it's alien eggs. Do you think it's possible that this is some kind of group crop circle imprinted in the ice?" The pair filmed the giant object before poking at it with their fingers and confirming its slimy texture, leaving them to believe it could be alien eggs. Now, ice has been known to form some unusual shapes. Spinning ice circles are fairly common and easily explained by gases rising from the lake floor and creating warm currents. But this thing looks more like a crop circle of some kind, according to comments online. And no one has been able to explain what those strange pods might be. Now let's get ready for today's missing topic. The Thing is a 1982 science fiction horror film directed by John Carpenter that tells the story of a group of researchers in Antarctica who encounter The Thing, a parasitic extraterrestrial life form that assimilates, then imitates other organisms. They also discovered a spacecraft frozen in the ice that looks a lot like this does. Is this image capturing the same thing? A spacecraft embedded in a glacier in Antarctica? In 2011, almost 30 years after the movie was made, a self-proclaimed UFO researcher found what he believes to be alien outposts in Antarctica. He analyzed satellite photos of Antarctica via Google Earth and says the photos show UFOs and other creatures. So maybe there's some truth to an image like this. Perhaps there's an alien presence waiting in the ice, waiting to be unburied. Do you believe that? Comment below using the hashtag #missingtopic and join the conversation. Hey, did you know that if you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you're more likely to win the lottery? So what are you waiting for? Melting mammoth tusk glaciers. In this remote region in Russia, the frozen ground is studded with the remains of prehistoric mammoths. Their tusks are worth a fortune to traders in other countries. Although the trade is still not fully regulated, searching for and selling mammoth tusks is completely legal in Russia. Siberian hunters once relied on mammoths for their meat. Now their tusks are the prize. These relics, exposed by climate change, and hunters' increasing efforts to dig them up, can fetch tens of thousands of dollars, inspiring a bustling trade. Every year, crews of people head to the region to dig up the tusks of woolly mammoths that lie frozen in the permafrost. They sleep in makeshift tents, live off canned beef, noodles, and vodka, and operate illegally, ripping the mammoth remains from the earth with a level of brute force never seen before. When hunters extract valuable tusks from the skeletons of the ancient buried animals, they also destroy evidence of past life on Earth. But the payoffs are huge for these hunters, and this is Siberia's gold rush, not in precious metals like diamonds and gold, but in body parts and bone. Tusk hunters can earn up to $100,000 a week. Gigantic frozen squid. It was quite a morning in Antarctica's remote Ross Sea during the season when the sun never sets. A fishing crew hauled up a creature with tentacles like fire hoses and eyes like dinner plates from a mile below the surface. A colossal squid, one of the sea's most elusive species. The squid, weighing 770 pounds and the size of a minibus, had been frozen for 8 months, and scientists got a long-anticipated chance to thaw out the animal and inspect it. They used a forklift to maneuver it into a tank. It was that big. The squid was a female, and its 8 arms were each well over 3 feet long. Its 2 tentacles would have been perhaps double that length if they had not been damaged. Colossal squid sometimes inhabit the world of fiction and imagination, but has rarely been seen in daylight. It's possible that ancient sightings of the species gave rise to tales of the kraken or giant sea monster squid. They're big, but incredibly, they can survive by eating just a single fish for months. It has eyes that are 10.6 inches in diameter, meaning that even the eye of a colossal squid is the largest eye in the animal kingdom. And after this monumental catch, all eyes are on the colossal squid. Amazing anaconda ice caves. This kind of natural formation is the kind of thing that gets our imagination going. What exactly will we find at the end of this anaconda ice cave? No doubt, this is an incredible experience, entering a glacier and seeing the pure crystal ice within. Also known as the crystal ice cave, this glacier gets its name because of its crystal blue ice, and the cave, it's called anaconda because of its long and winding shape, as if a giant serpent had carved a pathway through it. The ice cave is more than 200 feet deep on one end, and through a turn in the cave, you'll find an astonishing opening that is, in fact, another entrance to the anaconda. It's part of the Vatna Glacier, the largest ice cap in Europe, covering an estimated 8% of Iceland. The Anaconda Ice Cave is the largest natural ice cave in Iceland to be found in years, and you'll find it mesmerizing for its sheer size, charming colors, enchanting texture, and the absolute tranquil feeling inside. The ice appears to be glowing. The tunnel appears to be infinite. There's a tiny waterfall streaming off the ice ceiling near the entrance, testifying that ice caves are an ever-changing natural phenomenon. Anaconda Ice Cave is still in the making. Crazy frozen lighthouse. Lighthouses on Lake Michigan go through a lot, and as you can see by the amount of ice on this poor beacon, the struggle is very real. It resembled ice sculptures after they completely froze over when the region was with a cold snap recently. Check out these huge, magnificent icicles dangling from the St. Joseph Lighthouse in Michigan, making it look like a frozen fairy tale. Built in 1859, the two-story lighthouse sits exposed to the elements. Wind conditions caused waves of up to 10 feet on the lake, breaking up the ice and splashing the lighthouse. After this happened repeatedly, the icicles on the lighthouse were formed. The winter's freeze can be particularly bitter, with record super low temperatures recorded across the Midwest and Plains regions caused by a polar vortex blowing south from the Arctic. And look at what the chilly weather did. The height to which it covers the lighthouse truly demonstrates the power of the lake. It can be quite unnerving when the large icicles looming overhead, the inner and outer lighthouse, the catwalk along the North Pier, as well as a beacon on the South Pier, was all heavily encased in ice. Just breathtaking, if not otherworldly. Frozen forest beneath glacier. You might be able to see Russia from Alaska, but if you're making the trip up north, you have to check out the Mindenhall Glacier, a glacier in the Mindenhall Valley that formed over 3,000 years ago, and even more so now. An ancient forest has thawed from under the melting glacier and is now exposed to the world for the first time in more than 1,000 years. Stumps and logs have been popping up from underneath the Mindenhall Glacier, a 36.8 square mile river of ice flowing into a lake near Genoa, for nearly the past 50 years. Just within the past year or so, researchers have noticed considerably more trees popping up, many in their original upright position, and some still bearing roots and even a bit of bark. The team has tentatively identified the trees as either spruce or hemlock, based on the diameter of the trunks and because these are the types of trees growing in the region today. As glaciers advance, they often emit summer meltwater streams that spew aprons of gravel beyond the glacier's edge. A gravel layer appears to have encased the trees before the glacier ultimately advanced enough to plow over them, preserving the stumps in an icy tomb. Frozen fish comes back to life. Can fish and other aquatic creatures really survive in a state of suspended animation until spring? Yeah, it's true. Sometimes. The fish is frozen solid, but comes back to life in minutes after being placed in a pot of warm water. The clip shows these sea creatures floating motionless for a couple of seconds, but sure enough, after a nice warm bath, the fish gets resurrected. It then flaps its body vigorously and thrashes the water as it appears to regain consciousness. But can they be revived after extended times frozen in ice? The surprising answer is again yes, sometimes. It's true that some fish can spend the winter frozen in ice and come out swimming once the ice melts. They're able to shut down basic bodily functions, slow their metabolism, and enter a dormant state. Cold water fish that live in freezing areas are able to produce antifreeze agents in their blood to help them withstand freezing temperatures. And due to the fish being relatively small, they're able to warm up at a faster rate. The bizarre phenomenon is actually a very common method of keeping fish fresh in Japan, just enough to slow their heart rate, but not enough to kill them. This keeps their sushi meat fresh and tender. Antarctic ice fish. True to their name, the Antarctic ice fish live in the icy cold waters of the Arctic, and their cold habitat has given them some interesting features. Icy looking blood to match. The first ice fish was discovered in 1927 by a zoologist who pulled up a strange, pale fish during an expedition to Antarctic waters. The fish he pulled up was eventually named the blackfin ice fish. There are many species of ice fish, but they all have heads that look a little like a crocodile. So they're sometimes called crocodile ice fish, and they can grow to a maximum length of about a foot. As for the clear blood, the red of our blood is caused by hemoglobin, which carries oxygen throughout our body. Ice fish don't have hemoglobin, thus they have a whitish, nearly transparent blood. Despite the lack of hemoglobin, ice fish can still get enough oxygen, although scientists aren't quite sure how. It could be because they live in already oxygen-rich waters and might be able to absorb oxygen through their skin, or because they have large hearts and plasma, which may help transport oxygen more easily. The cold, well-mixed, oxygen-rich waters of the Southern Ocean provided an environment where a fish with a low metabolic rate could survive, even without hemoglobin, albeit less efficiently. But it still doesn't stop this ice fish. Headless chicken monster. A deep-sea swimming sea cucumber has been filmed in the Southern Ocean off East Antarctica for the first time, and you're not gonna believe how unique it is. Commonly known as the headless chicken sea monster, the creature had previously only been filmed in the Gulf of Mexico. It's actually a sea cucumber that ranges in size from 4 to 10 inches long. Its most distinct feature is its coloring, which is dictated by size. Small ones are bright pink, and larger individuals are a more reddish-brown color. It's also semi-transparent, and its intestine can be seen through its body, especially after feeding. They can also be bioluminescent. Species in this genus have developed webbed, swimming fin-like structures at the front and back of their bodies, which enable them to swim up off the surface of the seafloor and to journey as much as 3,300 feet up into the water column. This is thought to help the animals move to new feeding grounds and avoid predators. They spend most of their time in the water column, touching down on the seafloor only to eat. The first sighting in the Southern Ocean waters ever occurred in 2018. When a team from Australia caught an image of this headless chicken monster sea cucumber while being deployed in seas near East Antarctica. But trust us, it probably does not taste like chicken. Lake Vostok. After decades of drilling, Russian scientists in the Arctic have uncovered a rare piece of nature. An ancient lake buried thousands of feet under the ice, a gigantic freshwater lake hidden for some 20 million years. Lake Vostok is one of the largest subglacial lakes in the world. It's believed to be the 16th largest lake in the world, similar in size to the Great Lake Ontario. A team of 10 scientists dove deep to collect data on sea organisms and deploy incubation chambers along the seafloor. And space-based radar revealed this subglacial body of fresh water, one of some 140 subglacial lakes in Antarctica. Covered with ice for millennia, cut off from light and contact with the atmosphere, this lake is one of the most extreme environments on Earth. The lake is estimated to have been sealed off under the thick ice sheet 15 million years ago. It may hold life from the distant past and clues to the search for life on other planets. The lake has at least 22 cavities of liquid water, averaging 6 miles each. Its only water supply is meltwater from overlying ice sheets. However, this constant replenishment from melting ice means the water in the lake may be relatively young, just thousands of years old. But the true age of the lake water is unknown. Crazy frozen alligators. These reptiles cannot generate their own body heat, and bone-chilling Arctic air has created dangerous conditions for these alligators. In response to the cold, there's a survival technique called brumation. Alligators brumate by slowing down their metabolism and becoming lethargic. An ancient survival mechanism is kicking in. This allows them to regulate their body temperature and survive all kinds of weather. In a rarely seen occurrence, alligators can be seen trying to stay alive in a frozen North Carolina pond by sticking their snouts through the ice. Check out these cold-blooded reptiles at the Shallout River Swamp Park in Ocean Isle Beach, breathing through the gaps created with their snouts in a pond frozen by a brutal cold spell that ravaged parts of the U.S. Ordinarily, these alligators would be spending their time sunbathing, And now we can see the animals adopting a very different way of dealing with the punishing cold spell. They poked their noses out of the water as it began to freeze over, their scaly snorkels becoming their only conduit for oxygen. During extremely cold years, they can stay still for much of the season. As the season ends, their bodies will return to normal temperatures. New Antarctic life. Despite occupying nearly 400 million acres, ice shelves are amongst the least known environments on Earth. Life has been seen in these perpetual dark, cold, and still habitats on camera, but has rarely been collected. And now we know, far beneath the ice shelves of the Antarctic, there's more marine life than expected. Of the fragments of life on the seabed, the biodiversity of the specimens they collected was extremely rich. In fact, richer than many open water samples found on the continental shelf where there's light and food sources. The research team discovered an incredible 77 species. So the big question is, how do these animals survive and flourish here? There must be enough algae carried under the ice shelf from open water to fuel a strong food web. Microscopy of samples showed that, surprisingly, the annual growth of four of the species was comparable with similar animals in open marine environments. Another surprise was to find out how long life had existed here. Carbon dating of dead fragments of these seafloor animals varied from current to 5,800 years. So, despite living over a mile from the nearest open water, an oasis of life may have existed continuously for nearly 6,000 years under the ice shelf. Ancient Viking tunic. The rapid melting of glaciers over the past few years has resulted in hundreds of old archaeological items emerging from the ice in Norway. Archaeologists found what at first glance appears to be a rolled up piece of fabric, a well-preserved tunic from around 300 AD. That, plus arrow tips, tent pegs, and various hunting tools. The cloth shows signs of wear and tear, including a number of patches leading archaeologists to believe there were multiple owners of the tunic before it was abandoned. Norway's oldest garment, dating back 1,700 years, is known as the Lindbreen tunic. Examinations of the tunic show it was made from two different wool fabrics, both woven in a diamond twill. The tunic has no buttons or fasteners of any kind, so it was made to be pulled over the head and worn like a sweater. Based on where the tunic was found and the artifacts found around it, archaeologists think the last owner of it was probably hunting reindeer on the glacier. While the ice preserved it and the other textiles and objects for centuries, once the artifacts are exposed to air, decay begins immediately. Yet, skilled archaeologists and conservators managed to preserve hundreds of objects, including the tunic and at least 50 other cloth fragments. Incredible seed vault. Located in the Arctic Circle, in the dark corners of any icy mountain between Norway and the North Pole, stands a resource designed to secure our future on Earth, Svalbard Vault. Millions of tiny seeds from more than a million varieties of food crops are stored in this global seed vault on the Norwegian island of Spitsbergen. Ever heard of a seed bank? The vault is the ultimate insurance policy for the world's food supply, giving options for future generations to manage the challenges of a changing climate and population growth. It's not coal, oil, or precious minerals like diamonds or gold. It's seeds. The Global Seed Vault isn't simply just a large storage facility for seeds from around the world. The vault is protecting the world's agricultural genetic diversity and protecting our future in case of catastrophe. Worldwide, many gene banks like this one can hold collections of food crops. However, many of these are vulnerable, exposed to natural catastrophes and war. On top of that, something like a poorly functioning freezer can destroy an entire seed selection. That won't happen in this chilly environment. It's a long-term storage facility, like a huge safety deposit box built to stand the test of time. The Svalbard Vault will secure for centuries millions of seeds. Bleeding Ice Waterfall. 5 stories high and emerging from the Taylor Glacier in the dry valleys of Antarctica, blood falls seep into an ice-covered body of water called Lake Bonnie. The name itself is scary. Blood falls literally looks like blood pouring out of the earth. Some 2 million years ago, a body of water was sealed under the glacier, which contained an ancient community of microbes. Trapped below a thick layer of ice, they've remained there ever since, isolated inside a natural time capsule. And now, It's one of the continent's most enigmatic natural features. What makes it red? Does it always flow? And can anything actually survive near it? The trapped lake has a very high salinity and is rich in iron, which gives the waterfalls its red color. A fissure in the glacier allows the subglacial lake to flow out, forming the falls without contaminating the ecosystem within. And there you have it. Blood Falls gives researchers the opportunity to study deep subsurface microbial life in extreme conditions and to understand the range of conditions to which life can adapt. This information could help uncover the possibility of life elsewhere in the solar system. There's more to discover underneath the ice than we could ever imagine. Wouldn't you agree? Leave a comment below, like and subscribe, and share with your friends.